families compete to name the most popular responses to a survey of some simple questions. The answers are locked into our game board, and every point is worth 50 rand. In round 3 and 4, the points are doubled and then tripled in round 5. The family with the most points at the end of round 5 play for a jackpot of 75,000 rand. South Africa, it's time to play Family Feud. Give it up for Steve Harvey.
Welcome to the show, buddy. How y'all doing? Welcome to the show. How y'all? Thank y'all very much. I appreciate that. Thank y'all. Yeah, I do. Thank you, everybody. I appreciate it. Well, welcome to Family Feud South Africa, everybody. I'm your man, Steve Harvey. Well, we got a special show for you tonight with some of your favorite soapy stars in the studio playing for their favorite charity. Yeah. All right, welcome to the show, celebrities. This is how the show works. We've had our researchers that have been on the streets of Mzansi. Yeah. They have been asking you some answers to some very simple questions. We have those answers locked in on the game board up here. Whichever team, whichever soap opera, whichever group of stars gathers the most points at the end of the game will have a chance to win a jackpot, 75,000 rand for charity. Get it on and meet the teams. We have the team from House of Zwide. Yeah! And they're playing against Team Scandal.
Yeah!
All right. Y'all ready for the show to get started? Everybody say yeah. Yeah! Give me my Loxy, give me Lusanda. Okay, did I get the name right?
Pronounced? Yeah, Motlatsi.
Motlatsi.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, that was good. Lusanda.
That's correct.
Got it. Pleasure to meet y'all, man.
Thank
Welcome
you so
to
much.
The show.
You
too. Yeah. Let's you. Go. Come on. We surveyed 100 people. We got top 7 answers on the board. Give me a South African term of endearment for the love of your life. Lusanda.
Mapebeza.
Yeah. Ow, 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 ow. Good answer.
Say that again.
Mapebeza.
Yeah. Well, you sound like you meant it, though. I don't know. Mapebeza.
Sweetie.
Sweetie. Wadile.
Standa sam. Yeah. Standa sam.
Hey, dog, did you hear the question? That's your answer. Ty, what's up now?
Yes! 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 Yes!
Come on, let's play. I ain't even gonna ask you. Let's play. Y'all know I ain't gonna know the answers to none of these, right?
All right.
Sweetie wasn't up there, I'm out. So how are you?
We're great, thank you.
Good.
How are you doing?
So what role do you play on the show?
I play Boniswa. She's evil, she's sweet, she's a mother, she's everything you can absolutely think of. Dang.
Well, Lusanda, introduce your team.
All right, this is Wandi. Wandi plays Duma in the show. He's the damaged child, the special child, the addict, you know, that kind of character. Yeah. And then over there, we've got Nobile. Nobile plays the journalist, Hlengiwe. So yeah. She's always looking for everybody's secrets.
Yeah.
Yeah. You can call her Nunu as well. Huh. You know, if you struggle with a Nobile, you can go Nunu.
Nunu?
Nunu.
Okay, yeah, I'm gonna go with that. Yeah. Okay.
All right, then we've got Sandile. Sandile plays Simo, and he kind of the one that's been with every woman in the show in a very short space
My
of
man,
time.
My man, come on.
Hey, Steve, you know.
Somebody gotta do it.
Somebody gotta do it.
Pimping ain't easy.
No, it ain't easy.
But somebody gotta
Let
do it.
Let me tell you something.
Might as well be me.
Might as well be. I have to take the fall for everything.
Man,
you know?
I feel for you.
It's tough, Steve.
Yeah. 30 years ago, oh, I'd have loved it. Now, mm-mm, trying to go to heaven now. I'm too close to the gate. All right, who else?
And then we've got Hauser. Hauser plays Lerumo, the cop of the show, so.
No, what's his name?
Hauser.
Hauser.
Yeah. Mm.
This is my ID name, Tseppo.
Oh, that's Tseppo.
Yeah, that's
Tseppo. Oh, that ain't Hauser.
We call him Hauser.
Okay, because I was finna say, now I know good hair well. Tseppo, I know good hair well, that ain't Hauser. See, because y'all playing, you kept saying Hauser, and I'm looking at T-S-H-E, Hauser. Okay. Hell no. Tseppo.
Tseppo, that's my man.
What charity you guys playing for?
We're playing for a charity in the Eastern Cape, in Case Kamahok, called Kobo Kobo. They do their music.
You need to stop. Y'all need to quit playing with me. You know, No, we're not finna do that. You playing for who again?
So it's a music academy, Case Kama, in Kobo Kobo. Yeah.
Girl, you better stop. So, you are who on the show again?
Hlengiwe, a journalist.
A journalist?
Yes.
Yes, you married?
No.
Really? Yes.
I'm still in my 20s.
That's good. So are my sons. Yeah.
Well, where they at?
Oh, don't worry, they here. Oh, they here. Yeah. Yeah. Welcome to the United States of America.
You got any daughters?
Huh?
You have any daughters?
Yeah, but nah, I'll kill you about the daughters. Yeah, I done killed several people about them daughters.
Ooh,
so.
Nice, cool.
Now, not your pimp ass can't get my daughters, though. You a little playboy. Tired. Okay, let's play. Give me a South African term of endearment for the love of your life.
Spouse.
Spouse.
Good answer, Steve. Good answer.
My brother, so okay, yeah, you the player on the show.
Not necessarily, I don't like that. I just feel like, you know, they come over this way. The man is focused.
You focused, but the women come to you.
That's what I'm saying, yeah. No, to the character. Let's not,
yeah,
you know, let's
I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah, the man is focused, the man has a plan. Yeah. He's driven, he wants money.
Yeah.
You know, that's all he wants, and then just happens that he has to sleep with a woman now and then, you know, just to, and it's not, look, hey, man, I'm just acting. Okay, I'm just acting the show. I'm just letting everybody know. Why is everybody looking at me like that?
Because don't nobody believe you. It's all good, dog. You ain't acting that damn good. Don't look like acting to me. They watch the show. Does it look like he acting?
No.
You're very convincing.
I'm just a good actor.
Ladies and gentlemen, Denzel Washington. Yeah. All right, man, we got one strike. Give me a South African term of endearment for the love of your life.
Lovey.
Lovey. Okay, Tseppo.
Tseppo.
We got two strikes. We got to be careful, man. The House of Zwide can steal. Give me a South African term of endearment for the love of your life.
My chocolate.
My chocolate. Chocolate!
Yes! You back at it, baby!
How's it waiting? Give me a South African term of endearment for the love of your life.
Bae. Yeah.
Bae.
Yeah.
Hey, bae.
Bae.
Hey, bae. Hey,
bae. All right, let's look at the remaining answers. Number 7. 6. 5. 4. We're getting close now. Number 2. Well, we got a game, folks. House of Zwide not on the board. Scandal got 31. Don't go away, y'all. We'll be right back. We're playing Family Feud. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. The house is already not on the board. Scandal got 31. Give me Pablo. Give me one daily.
Yes, sir.
All right, did I say it right?
Yeah, I go by Pablo, but the full name is Pablo.
Full name is Pablo.
Pablo.
Pablon.
Oh, damn. Pablo.
Pablon.
There you go.
Okay, you just say skipping, huh? You tired of me,
I'm
dog?
Tired of that.
He looked at me with just, hey, man, Pablo, just go with that. All right, brothers, welcome to the show. We've surveyed 100 people. We got top 7 answers on the board. Tell me, why would a woman need to wear a duke on her head?
Yo.
A wedding.
A wedding. Every time he give an answer, it's number one.
Yeah.
Come on, player. Yeah. Let's go.
Yes. No, I, yes.
Nah.
You ready?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Tell me why a woman would need to wear a duke on her head.
To maintain her hairstyle.
To maintain her hairstyle.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Yes, Nunu.
Yes,
Nunu. I guess, you know, I guess... Okay, first of all, what is a duke?
Ndugu. It's... Oh, sorry for saying it like that.
No, that's just how you say it. Say it the real
way. Ndugu, like...
Ndugu.
Can be like a silk material, skirt in shape. You just
oh, a scarf.
It.
A bandana.
Yeah.
Oh, not a bandana.
Oh, a scarf. A like scarf. A bandana. Yeah. Oh, you wrap bandana? Your head.
Yeah.
Oh, so at bedtime, it keeps your hairstyle in place. Oh, okay, yeah, that's cool. Okay. Yeah. All right, let's go. My man, you ready?
Yes, sir.
Tell me, why would a woman need to wear a...
Dugu.
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 Dugu. On her head.
It's a funeral.
Yeah. To a funeral. My man, tell me why would a woman need to wear a duke on her head?
To go to church.
To go to church.
Yeah,
boy. All right, all right, all right.
You are married.
Yes, I am.
Wonderful. How long you been married?
15 years.
15, wow. You have children?
Excited.
How many children?
2, a boy and a girl.
A boy and a girl?
Yes.
How old are they?
12 and 13.
Really?
Yes.
Wow, that's pretty good. All right, we got no strikes. Tell me why a woman would need to wear a duke on her head.
Church funeral. Oh, the time. Sorry, guys. Sorry.
I don't know. Just, okay. My man, tell me why would a woman need to wear a duke on her head?
To go swimming.
To go swimming.
Okay, good answer. Oh my gosh.
To put a scarf on your head to go swimming. Yeah. That'll keep the water off.
Guys, you're doing it for good.
Come on.
Huh?
When you said that, did you kind of know? Right after you said
as it came out, I was like, oh.
Yeah, it probably ain't gonna be
yeah,
up there,
though.
Yeah,
ain't gonna
be right. All right. Hey, we got 2 strikes now. We gotta be careful.
Mm.
The house of Zwidde can steal. Tell me, why would a woman need to wear a duke on her head?
To hide bad hair.
To hide bad hair. Yeah. To hide bad hair.
Oh. Oh, no.
Oh, man. Here we go. No. We got 2 strikes. Gotta be careful. House is away that can steal. Tell me, why would a woman need to wear a duke on her head?
Well, fashion sense.
For fashion. Boy, y'all done came out of nowhere. See, what y'all needed was a little pressure. First, you just needed to get 2 strikes. Now you know every damn thing. All right, Tempo, we got to be careful, man. We got 2 strikes. House is where they can steal. Only 1 answer left on the board. You could clear it. Tell me, why would a woman need to wear a duke on her head?
Jeez, like, I...
Mm-hmm. Tell me, why would a woman need to wear a duke on her head?
When she's cleaning?
Yeah.
When she's cleaning. That's a good answer. When she's cleaning. Number six. Well, that was round two, everybody. House is awaiting, not on the board. Scandal got 115. Don't go away. When we come back, the celebs are gonna be playing for double the points. You got a long way to go. You're still in it. Don't worry about it. We'll be right back, y'all. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. House is away, they not on the board. Scandal got 115. Give me Londeka, give me Nunu.
Oh. Hi.
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. How are you?
Oh my God.
Oh my this word.
Yes, I told you, I have two sons, I told you.
Oh no, yeah.
Oh my God, thank you, Lord. Oh my God, I have found them. Marjorie picked my son's wife. She was walking as a model in a fashion show. Marjorie was at the fashion show. And after the show, she stopped her and said, I would like for you to meet my son. They are married and have four children. In this round, we've doubled the points, surveyed 100 people. Top six answers on the board. Name something pastors do when they get excited during a sermon. Nunu.
Shout.
Shout.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
You can still answer. One answer, beat it.
They speak in tongues.
Speak in tongues. Oh. Pass or play?
We're playing.
Play. Let's go. Okay. Okay. All right, Sandile.
Yes, sir.
Here we go, man. Name something pastors do when they get excited during the sermon.
They dance.
They dance. So this is the exact same thing that's happening at our black churches in the States. I just want you to know, you ain't saying nothing new here. All this speaking in tongues, shouting, dancing in the spirit, all that. I grew up, my mother was a Sunday school teacher. I grew up in a Pentecostal church. Drums, tambourines, shouting, singing all day.
That's not 5 hours.
All day. Every day, Monday night prayer meeting, Tuesday night Bible study, Wednesday night choir rehearsal, Thursday board, usher board meeting number one, usher board meeting number two, three, four, five. Saturday was a car wash and a bake sale for the building fund that we never put a doorknob on the church. Sunday, early morning service, late night service. We was there every day. I was really, really, when I was 9, I was really considering going to hell. All right, come on, man. Give me something pastors do when they get excited during the sermon.
Quote scriptures.
Quote scriptures. It's just one strike. That's a lot for one strike. That's a lot. Don't scare me like that no more. Hey! All right, Lusanda, give me something pastors do when they get excited during a sermon.
Amen.
Amen. Wadile, only one strike, brother. Tell me something pastors do when they get excited during a sermon.
Send the offering basket around.
Well, that's okay.
I'm excited now. How about that money? Put some money in there.
Oh, my gosh.
Give till you bleed. Pass around the offering.
Oh, come on.
Nunu.
Yes.
Now, listen to me. Your new grandmother is going to want you to know everything about church. Oh, God. She's going to teach you scriptures. Oh, you're going to want to come back to Africa right away. But it'll be okay. She's very nice. Now, she's going to try to fatten you up, but don't let her do it. Don't listen to her. But she put gravy on everything. Thick gravy. Her and her husband put a straw in it, put it in a cup, and drink it. Drink it like it's soda. They got high blood pressure and everything. They put ice in it, be sitting up there watching TV, just sucking gravy through a straw. We're gonna stop, we're gonna die. Stop, we're gonna die. All right, here we go. Name something pastors do when they get excited during a sermon.
Anoint you.
They anoint you.
Yeah.
Come on, family. Give me something pastors do when they get excited during a sermon.
They sweat.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, they do. They sweat. Number four. Well, that's round three, everybody. We got a game now. House of Zwiede, 154. Scandal got 115. We got a game now. Don't go away, because after the break, we're going to be playing for double the points. We got two good teams here. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. We got a game now. House of Zwiede, 154. Yeah. Scandal got 115. Give me Kaya. Give me Sandele. All right, everybody. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
In this round, point values are double. Surveyed 100 people. Top six answers on the board. Name a service someone performs on you while you're sitting down.
Well, the oldest art form in the world, which is, come on. Do you want me to really, should I really? Yeah. Sex.
Took too long.
Massage.
Massage. Pass or play?
We playing!
We playing.
Yeah,
all right, man. I finally got over here.
Yeah.
Get to meet everybody. About time.
About time.
So, tell me about the show.
House of Zwiede is a new show. I'm on ETV. It's about fashion. It's about love. It's about some nice performance we got there. And yeah, man, it's new. I think you gotta watch it. I think it's the show to watch.
It's a new show.
Forward. Yeah.
Okay, so who do you play?
I play Molefe. Molefe, who's a a playboy, bad boy of the show. It's about money, it's about clothes, it's about making it, it's about family, family feud. Oh, wow, nice. Nice, Deka.
Exactly that.
They were trying to help you out. Yeah, they were trying to give you some words.
Yeah.
All right, man, introduce everybody.
Okay, we've got Pablo. Pablo plays Sandile on the show. He's an intern at the Zwiede house. He also caused some mischief there. And then we've got Londega, who is a daughter of Faith. And then we've got Kaya, who plays Lazarus. Lazarus is like the flower of House of Zwiede. He's like, when you enter the world, he just comes in and does the things. Right, and then we have Rhea, who's played by Matshepo. Oh, yeah. She plays my sister. She's the heart of the family, the show. She represents that warmth.
What charity you play for?
Sonke Gender Justice.
What?
In Brum.
Yeah, Sonke Gender Justice, it's in Brum. You know, there's a lot of GBV happening in the country. So we just wanna just support that initiative that we say no to women and children being abused.
Yes.
So that's what our group is about.
All right, good. So your role on the show is again?
Yes. I am Rhea. I play his sister. I'm a mother. I'm a wife.
Okay.
At least I get to be a wife at some point in my life.
Oh, one of them. Going through it, having a moment. I get to be a wife at one point. But it's gonna happen. But see, here's what happened. See, you're on TV now.
Yes.
I have been on TV for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
I know how fame works.
Mm-hmm.
One season of TV, okay.
Yeah.
The longer you stay on TV, the more known you become. It becomes to be a pain after a while.
Yeah.
Because let me tell you something about being famous. Being famous is like living in a big, pretty prison.
Yeah.
Yeah.
True.
You lose all of your freedoms.
Yeah.
You can't go out in public when you want to. You can't eat where you want to.
You can't trust everybody.
You can't trust nobody.
No wonder the marriage is not coming.
Nothing.
Hey!
You going through some things, ain't you? She just down there. She ain't got no husband. She need a husband. Somebody stole something.
Trust issues.
Yeah, you got some real... Kaya say trust issues. You just down here dealing with it. Let's just play the game before you all right?
I'm good, thank you, yes.
It's good. Sometimes you got to get it out, though.
It's all out.
Because maybe I do it all the time.
Fresh.
Comedy was therapy for me. It allowed me to get a lot of stuff out. So I don't have that platform anymore, so I just tell jokes on this game show. Here we go. Name a service someone performs on you while you're sitting down.
Lip dance.
Hey, come on, girl. A lap dance.
Yay!
All right, so good. All right, here we go. We're playing.
Sure.
Name a service someone performs on you while you're sitting down.
Maybe braiding your hair or...
Braiding your hair!
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh!
Yay!
Yay.
Woo-hoo. Woo-hoo. Let's go, Pablo. Name a service someone performs on you while you're sitting down.
Damn. Mm.
Well done.
The audience is getting involved now. Oh,
It's okay.
Londika.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
How are you?
I'm well, thanks.
Have you ever been to Atlanta?
No, I haven't.
Oh, it's beautiful.
It's warm. I can imagine.
Trees everywhere.
Mm.
So many trees.
Mm.
Wonderful.
Mm.
Can you cook?
No, thing is, when you live with me, you're not gonna starve, you know? I cannot cookish, but I can.
It's okay.
You won't starve. The point is you won't starve.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, that's important.
Yeah.
Okay, you won't starve.
Mm.
But you're gonna be hungry. But you won't
starve.
We're gonna get you something.
You won't eat.
It's one of those, yeah.
Eat these two slices of bread till we think of something. That's good. Come on, darling. Name a service someone performs on you while you're sitting down.
Serves you food, restaurants, like. Ooh. Yeah.
Serves you food at a restaurant. Kaya? All right, now we got a little situation here. We got two strikes. Scandal can steal. Now you gotta nail this one. Name a service someone performs on you while you're sitting down.
Doing your nails.
You better know it. Doing your nails.
That's it.
Manicure, pedicure.
I nailed it.
Yeah. Come on now.
Yeah.
a step on.
Yes.
Now, here we go. Now, I know we're working through some issues in your life, but we're just looking for two answers. We got two strikes. We got to be careful. Scanner can speak.
Okay.
Now, I know you're probably going through some things, but I want you to name a service that someone performs on you while you're sitting down.
A medical?
A medical.
A medical.
A medical.
Honey. Yeah.
That was a good answer. That was a good answer. All right, family. Name a service someone performs on you while you're sitting down.
Makeup.
Makeup. Number six. Five.
Dentistry.
All right, everybody, listen up carefully. This is the last round, and everybody, there is everything to play for right now, because whoever has the most points at the end of this round will have a chance to play for the jackpot, the fast money jackpot, 75,000 Rand for charity. House of Zwede, 322. Scandal, 115. Let's get it on. Give me my Sepo. Give me Sepo. Oh, top five answers. Oh, in this round, everybody, point values are triple. Surveyed 100 people. Top five answers are on the board. Here we go. Name the worst thing about being an actor who plays a villain on TV. Seppo.
Getting angry.
Being hated.
Being hated. Yeah! Pass or play?
Play.
Play.
Let's go, man. Let's play. Lysandra, darling, name the worst thing about being... Are you a villain on TV?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah.
You are?
Yeah, she is.
Wow.
They know.
Name the worst thing about being an actor who plays a villain on TV.
The emotional turmoil.
The emotional turmoil.
You gotta think.
It's a good answer, because who else would know except someone who plays? But this game, we survey 100 people, and probably ain't none of them actors.
Interesting.
So this is gonna be... You might have to think outside the box a little bit on this one, because you ask a regular person, all I know is everybody hates you. After that, hell, I don't know what... I'm getting paid. I don't give a damn how you feel about me, partner. I get hated on the internet all the time. I be living that stuff. Them people don't even know me.
Yeah, man.
They ain't shakers and movers and decision makers.
Come on.
They
now.
Are thumb gangsters.
Come on now.
They got a and you got no life.
Wow, this question.
The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred with dust, blood, sweat, and tears. Amen. Not to those cold and timid souls in the stands who know neither victory nor defeat.
Amen.
So when they hating on you, they hating on you because they ain't you. All of them want to be on TV, dog. So now they ain't on TV, now they got something to say.
Yeah.
Haters.
Haters.
Haters make you greater.
Hey.
I love them. I love haters. All right, let's go, man. We all got one strike. Name the worst thing about being an actor who plays a villain on TV.
You can't get a cab. No?
So now, oh, so you're a villain on TV. They hate you so much, they don't even pick your ass up.
Yeah.
cannot get a cab. Wow, we got two strikes. Come on now, we gotta slow down. House of Zwidey can steal.
Oh no.
Nunu?
Yes.
We got two strikes, darling. We have to be careful. Name the worst thing about being an actor who plays a villain on TV.
One day every villain has to die.
What? You know what? The thing about you, Nunu, is every time I come to you, your answer is on the board. Let's keep the streak alive. Eventually, you're going to be murdered in front of everybody. Oh, no.
Now the pressure is on me.
All right, man, I see you heavy. You're thinking about it. Come on, man, we got two strikes. House is away, they can steal.
It's heavy over here.
Name
right
the worst thing about being an actor who plays a villain on TV. You kind of a villain.
Yeah.
What's the worst thing about it, man?
It's a lot of work, Steve.
It's a lot of work.
It's a lot of work.
It's a lot of work.
Thank you, Sandile.
Well, team, here's the deal. The newest, the hottest show on television on ETV. This is the deal. I got three answers on that board. If you give me either one of those answers, your team clears the board, your team wins the points, you win the game, and you're gonna be playing for 75,000 Rand for your charity. But if you don't give me one of those three answers, Scandal will be playing for 75,000 Rand. Now, I'm okay either way, because both of my young new daughter-in-laws are gonna be out here, one of them. Come on, dog. Name the worst thing about being an actor who plays a villain on TV.
People can attack you because they're scared of you.
People what? Say it again.
People can attack you because they're scared
people
of you.
People can yes attack you
yeah,
because
the shopping
they're scared
complex,
of you.
Wherever what? You go.
You get attacked. Number four. Two. Well, Team Scandal, you don't go away empty-handed. You're gonna take away 5,750 Rand and another 10,000 Rand from KFC, making it a total of 15,750 Rand for your charity. Nice to meet y'all. Good luck, stay with it. Look, don't ever give up. Don't ever give up. You'll never know. Hey, I need two of you right here to play Fast Money.
Come on. Woo!
I got Pablo, I got Kyle. We're gonna be right back. We're gonna play Fast Money. Jackpot, 75,000 Rand. Welcome back to the Feud, everybody. House of Zwidey won the game. And now it's time to play
Fast Money.
All right, Kyle, here's how Fast Money works. Pablo is off stage. He can't see or hear any of your answers. I'm gonna ask you five questions in 20 seconds. You can't think of something, you just say pass. If we have enough time, I'll get back to it. You and Pablo together come up with 200 points. Tell everybody what you're gonna win for your charity.
$75,000.
Yeah. All righty. Are you ready?
I am ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Besides Simba, name another popular character in The Lion King.
Rafiki.
A country famous for its food.
India.
A tool gardeners use.
A shovel.
A type of white wine.
Chardonnay.
something you buy for your eyes.
Sunglasses.
All right, let's see how we did. All right, Kyle, let's go. Besides Simba, name another popular character in The Lion King. You said Rafiki. Survey said? A country famous for its food. You said India. Survey said? A tool gardeners use. You said shovel. Survey said? Yeah. A type of white wine. You said Chardonnay. Survey said? Something you buy for your eyes. You said sunglasses. Survey said? Wow, there we go. That's a good job. That's a good job. Pablo.
You do.
How we feeling, man?
Feeling good.
Good, good, good. Well, Kaya did the thing now. Got 110 points. Okay. You need 90 points. Now, Pablo, listen to me. It's hard to get 90 points in the second position, so you really got to focus, okay?
All right.
To bring this thing home. All right, this is how we're gonna do it. I'm gonna ask you the same 5 questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again, you give me another answer. Now, it's gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we'll give you 25 seconds. You ready?
All right.
All right, let's remind everybody of Kaya's answer. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Besides Simba, name another popular character in The Lion King.
Timon.
A country famous for its food.
Italy.
A tool gardeners use.
A shovel.
Try again.
A spade.
Try again. A type of white wine.
A type of white wine?
Yeah.
Oh, damn, I don't drink.
Well tried.
All right, let's see how we did. We need 90 points. Besides Simba, name another popular character in The Lion King. You said... No idea who that is. Timon.
Timon?
Survey said...
What?
Yeah, well, I ain't heard of it.
Yeah.
Number one answer, Mufasa. Mufasa. A country famous for its food. You said Italy. Survey said? Yay. Oh, that's a big one. Italy was the number one answer. A tool gardeners use. You said spade was the number one answer. 48, spade and shovel, same thing. Oh, yeah. Yeah. We need 48. A type of white wine. Well, we didn't get it. You said you don't drink. Chardonnay was the number one answer. Kaya had that one.
Yes.
And we need 48. Something you buy for your eyes. We didn't get to that, so you said nothing. And so that. Spectacles, glasses was number one. Well, that's 152 points that you scored. You add that to your earlier score, you're walking out of here for your charity with 46,250 rand. That's pretty good. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks.